Hi guys, good morning. Welcome to An Academy Cat Life Daily. Yes guys, waiting for all my students to join in as fast as possible. I'm doing a class on analogies today and waiting for all my students to join in. Please let me know if you can hear me guys. Is my voice clear? Yes, guys, let me know if you can hear me clearly. Yes, all the students who are with me every day in the morning at 9:30, guys, waiting for you to join in for a very, very productive class on analogies. Aaj karna hai analogies. Analogies is an important question type. It often comes in the verbal section of various examinations. Good morning, Mansi. Good morning, Rugved. Yes, all the students who are with me in the morning. Okay, that's good. Thank you, Mansi. Yes, so let us go into the class. Yes, my name is Harpreet Kaur Dhodi. I've done my master's in English literature. I have 16 years of teaching experience. 16 years is a lot of experience with one kind of exam. Yes, I have also trained for MAT, ZAT, SNAP, PGCET, Banking, GRE, GMAT, SAT, ACT and TOEFL guys. I've also done a diploma in journalism and I like to create content. Right. Okay guys, so today I am a trainer on hashtag CatLifeDaily and I train students for all the management exams. So agenda today is to do analogies guys. Good morning Anand. Yes, so download the Telegram app livedaily.me/chat and join the Unacademy chat. I also have a personal Telegram group guys. I have a personal Telegram group and that is known as Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat. So all those who wish to connect with me directly can join this particular group on the Telegram, which is known as Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat. Right guys? Yes, so the cat subscription is the best in the industry. It is just 3,500 for 1 month. 2,917 for 3 months. Good morning, Chirayu. 2,333 for 6 months. 1,458 for 12 months. And 875 for 24 months. I think, guys, that it is very important that all students take the subscription because what happens in the plus does not necessarily happen in this particular platform. Yes, we are training you no doubt in YouTube and you're getting free classes on the YouTube and in the special classes. But if you want to maximize your scores and do your best in the examination, you must definitely take the plus courses. Why? Because you can interact with the educators on a more personal levels. The questions are at a higher quality. The kind of questions that we give as a content for plus courses is much better than what we have here. Yes, and also guys, you have leader polls, you have quizzes, you have doubt solving sessions. So all of that makes it money is worth. So it is hardly any money. 1,458 for 12 months is very, very reasonable, guys. I don't think anywhere in the industry you will get this kind of a price. In addition to that, the cherry on the cake is that if you use Core 10, you will get a further 10% discount. Yes, Sachin, Shivani, Vaishnavi, good morning. All my students who are with me every day in the morning, guys, please go ahead and take the plus courses. I can guarantee you that you will not regret ever taking the plus courses because you have educators teaching all day long. From morning till night, there are educators. You can choose your time. You can choose your educator. And you can also choose the topics that you want to take up. And therefore, it is something which is very, very productive, very viable. See that you do not forego this opportunity to join the PLUS program, guys. Yes, aaj karna hai analogies. What is an analogy? Analogy is to draw a parallel. Analogy is to draw a parallel. And this is a kind of question type which often comes in the management exams, guys. So let us go into what are the different kinds of analogies. Now, the analogy types that have been given are not exhaustive. In many books, the list may be extended to include more such pairs. However, the endeavor the faculty should is to look at the most important analogy types that are appearing in the CAT and management exams. So what I have done is, I have given you the different kinds of relationships, guys. We are going to discuss the different kinds of relationships which often occur in the CAT examination, which is not an exhaustive list. You can have many more of these relationships, but I have given you the ones which are the most important. Yes, good morning, Priyansh. How are you doing? Yes, so we will start with all the relationships which are followed by examples. The first one is a synonymous relationship. Synonymous means both words are similar. Both words are on the same line. They are both same words. Similar words is synonymous relationship. For example, salubrious means healthy. Yes, so this is one relationship. Pulchritudinous means beautiful. So these are both same meanings. They have the same meaning. Right? Yes. Parsimonious is miserly. Both are synonyms. Hairyocyte is hairy. These are also synonyms. So they mean the same thing. Same meaning is given. Good morning, Shivraj. How are you doing? Yes. So salubrious is healthy. Parsimonious is miserly. You can take screenshots and learn the meanings of these words also, guys. Pulchritudinous is beautiful. Hairyocyte, like, you know, you say animals which are hairyocyte, like bears and gorillas, they are hairy. So this is known as a synonymous relationship. Then I'm going to the next one is antonymous. Antonymous relationship is where both words are opposites. Both words are opposites, like opulent and penurious. Opulent is rich. Yes. Yes, Shaurya, you can join now. Why not? Please join in. Yes. Okay. You want me to wait, Shivraj, for what? Penurious is poor. Yes, fair is being just. You are noting it down? Okay, I am waiting, guys. Please write down the words. Fair and unjust. Fair means being just. Unfair is the opposite. Yes, insipid is something which is tasteless. Not having any spice. No namak mirchi. Very tasteless. Opposite is tasty. Ignorant, wise. Ignorant means not knowing anything. Wise is the opposite. So guys, you have opposite relationship. There are many kinds of relationship here. Yes. So what you need to do, guys, you can take down the screenshots. Shivraj, if you take screenshots, it will be better for you than writing it down. I think that is a better idea. Right, guys? Can I continue? Yes, because this is a very long lesson. Yes, degree of intensity. Now, sometimes the relationship is, the degree of relationship is like a smaller degree and a higher degree. So, this is a smaller degree. To like somebody is a smaller degree. Adore is a higher degree. Now, warm. It is very warm today. Small degree. Scorching heat means very, very hot. High degree of heat. Similarly, drizzle is a small degree of rainfall. So if it is raining all day long, it is just called a drizzle. While torrential rain is a higher degree. Summer is sudden. This is referring to snowfall. So if there is just a drop of snow, you call it a flurry, which is a smaller degree. Blizzard is B-L-I, it is called, guys. B-L-I-Z-Z-A-R-D is a very, very strong heavy snowfall is known as blizzard, right? So this is a degree relationship. So supposing I am telling you another example is whimper. Whimper and wail, both are crying sounds. Whimper is a small crying sound. Wail is a higher crying sound. Wailing means crying very loudly. So this is a small sound, this is a high sound. So this is known as degree of intensity. When you establish these kind of relationships, guys, for you to arrive at an answer will be easy. Otherwise, if you only look at antonyms and synonyms, you're mostly likely to go wrong because there are so many relationships as far as these kind of analogies are concerned. So is it fine, guys? I'm going to go to the next question. Part to whole. So they can also give you a part and whole relationship. For example, an archipelago is a group of islands. So this is the whole, and island is the part. Similarly, paragraph and essay. Paragraph is the part, essay is the whole. Right? Yes, strand is a part of the hair. So part and whole. blade is a part of the grass. So part and whole. So this is known as part and whole relationship, guys. Okay. Then you have what is known as tool to workman. What is the tool which is used by a workman? Like a scalpel is used by a surgeon. A chisel is used by a sculptor. A pen is used by a writer. A saw is used by a carpenter. So what is the tool used by each of these professions, these workmen? What is the tool that they use is what we are talking about here. Now, worker to workplace. So doctor works in a hospital. A miner works in a pit. A professor works in a college. An astronomer works in an observatory. So worker to workplace relationship is the sixth kind of relationship. Take screenshots, guys, because writing down all of them will be very time consuming. Yes. Okay. Worker to article. So what is the worker working on? Like a poet writes a sonnet. Sonnet is a kind of a poem. A dramatist writes a play. An architect creates a blueprint and an artist creates a fresco. Fresco is a painting. It is a painting, guys. Right? Yes. Okay. Next one, member to class. Like a kangaroo is a member of the marsupial class. Marsupials are kind of animals which carry their babies in their pockets. Similarly, crab is a part of the crustacean family. Whale is part of the mammal family and frog is an amphibian. So member to class. You get it, guys? Yes. Now coming to the next one is gender. Gender, we are talking about female and male, right? So you and Ram, female, male. Mare is a female, stallion is a male. Woman is a female, man is a male. Dog and stag, right? Again, female. Yes, actually this can be bitch and dog, right? Yes, you won't say stag here. So this will be female and male, right? Yes. Okay, so that is a slight correction there, guys. Yes. Okay, group. Now, this is known as what you call as collective nouns. This is collective nouns. Now, a pride of lions, a flock of sheep, a herd of cattle, a swarm of bees. So, collective nouns can also form groups. These are known as grammatical relationships. Then the cry of, the animal, like a dog whines, a man moans, the growl of a tiger, right? Yes. So this is also incorrect. We'll leave this out. Yes. So what is the sound? Like you say a dog barks, a dog will bark, a cat will mew, right? So what is the sound? Right? Okay. Adjective to quality. Now, you, for example, you say tigerine is savage. Tigerine. Bovine is cow-like. You also have others in this particular relationship, which is like saying canine is dog-like. Yes. Then you have what is known as feline. Feline is cat-like, right? So there are many words here, guys. Write down all the words ending in I-N-E. You will have many words where human beings behave like animals. So the adjective to quality. Tiger is always savage. Bovine is cow-like. That means very, very passive. Yes, feline is cat-like. Canine is dog-like. So this is known as adjective to quality relationship. Then you have tool to action, like a drill is used to make a bore, a crowbar is used to fry, a knife is used to cut, a needle is used to pierce, right? Yes. Okay, subject, study to subject, like ornithology is a study of birds, nephrology is a study of kidneys, philology is a study of words, paleontology is a study of fossils, ancient fossils, right? Okay. Instrument to aspect measured. Thermometer is used to measure temperature. Barometer is used to measure humidity. Speedometer, speed. Odometer, distance. So what is the instrument and what is it used to measure? This is the next kind of relationship, guys, 15. Then you have the phobias and manias, like kleptomaniac is a tendency to steal. Dispomaniac is a tendency to drink. Pyrophobia is a fear of fire. Hydrophobia is a fear of water. So phobias and manias have other relationships. So there are 16 and many more relationships, guys. Another thing that you can do is you can create a what is known as a matrix, right? And you will write down here what is known as the name of the animal, right? Hi, Tushar. Then you can write down here what is the male and female, what is the young one, what is the baby of the animal called, what is the meat called, and what is the rider called, right? So if I look at an animal, what is the male and female, what is the young one, right? So if I am talking about, let me say, take the animal like an elephant. An elephant, you will talk about young one is called a cub. Yes, baby is called, baby of the elephant is called a cub. Young one and baby being the same thing. So this will be the same one, guys. I was supposed to write here home. Where does the elephant live? What is the baby? What is the meat? The rider is a mahout. The writer is mahout. So create a matrix and then revise this before the examination. Most of the analogies which refer to animals are very, very basic, but we forget what is the male and female, what is the home, what is the baby, meat and rider. Right, guys? So do this particular matrix and write down all the words. It will be easier to revise. Okay, going to the questions now. In each of the following questions, a pair of words in capitals is given, followed by five numbered pairs of words. Select from the choices the pair which exhibits the same relationship as the capitalized pairs of words and mark the answer as your number. So what happens is, this is known as a regular analogy. Regular analogy is of this kind. Now two words are given to you. You have to establish the relationship of this pair and find the same relationship in the options. Right, sometimes they will also give you a reverse analogy. What is a reverse analogy is, you have to pick the odd man out. So if there are four options which have the same relationship, one will not share the same relationship, and that is known as the odd man out. Now look at advance and retreat. What do you think is the answer? Now I want your involvement, guys. Start answering the questions. Advance, retreat are antonyms. So which is the pair which is antonyms here? Yes, come on. Now the answers have to come from you. Yes, guys, I'm waiting for you to answer. Which is the pair which has the same relationship? Yes, come on. Forward and onward is synonyms, right? Going forward or onward is synonyms. Condemn, criticize is synonyms. You have to pick the opposites, antonyms. Condemn and criticize is also synonyms. Yes. Which one, guys? Retreat is to go back. No, forward and onward is the same. Onwards is going the same way. Yes, guys. Now, what is the answer? Now, the answer is push and pull. Push and pull. So, this is again the same action as advance and retreat. Now, these are also opposites, but they are not as parallel as push and pull. Right? Buy and sell is also opposites, but when you are advancing something, you are going forward and retreat is to pull. So therefore, the answer will be B, guys. Only one answer is correct. You can't have so many. Yes, they are opposites, but here push and pull is the same same as advance and retreat, right? Yes, therefore the answer will be B, guys. B is the answer. Okay? Yes, I'm going to go to the next one. So options are very, very close. You have to be careful in how you choose your options. You have to be careful. Okay, body, hand. This is known as part and whole. Part of the, this is the part of the body and this is the whole of the body. Right? This is whole. Yes. Okay, part and whole. So this one is the whole and this is a part. What is the answer? It's not degree, Anish. It is a whole and part relationship. Like I was telling you, spoon and cutlery. Cutlery is the whole, spoon is a part. Yes. Now pick the answer, guys. Yes, very good. Anish, Rugved, Gunjan, Sejal. Yes, Kushi. It's not chair and table. Chair is not necessarily a part of the table. Right? Yes, C is the answer. Automobile is the whole and wheel is the part. Automobile is the whole and wheel is the part. Right? Monikesh, Mansi, Tushar, Kushi, Vaishnavi, Shibu. C is the answer. Right, guys? Okay, let's go to the next one. Contemplate, ponder. Both of them means to think. To think or to mull. Mull over something. That means to reflect upon something. To reflect. Yes, what is the answer? What is the answer to the 19th one, guys? Yes, answer to 19th one. It is not fascinate, wonder. Fascinated means to be filled. Yes, is it A? Wonder means to think. Fascinated means to be attracted or captivated. Right, so it cannot be A, guys. Yes, Ayush is giving me the correct answer. D is to captivate and capture. Captivate is to attract. Capture is to imprison. Admire, despise, opposites. Mitigate is to appease or to lessen. Reject is the opposite. Right, so answer is fabricate and feign, guys. Fabricate is to make up. He fabricated a story. Make up and feign is to pretend. Fabricate, feign is the answer. Yes, answer is C, guys. Feign means to pretend. To pretend to do something. Right? So, therefore, the answer is C. Okay, I'm going to go to the next one. Water has depth. So, how do you measure water? Depth. Yes, what is the answer? 28th one. Yes, waiting for the answer to come up from you guys. No, it is not A, Sejal. Water has depth. Shivani, Monikesh, Sejal. Rule or law is synonyms. color strength, it cannot be density of the mass. Yes, which one, guys? Height does not have feet. Height is measured in feet. So water has depth, ocean has fathoms. Fathom is a unit of measurement. Unit of measurement of the ocean. How do you measure the ocean? Is known as fathom. Yes, so the water has depth, the ocean has fathoms. Yes, guys, so answer will be E. Yes, Vaishnavi, E is the answer. So how do you measure it? It is E. Density, mass, if the order is reversed, guys, mass has density is okay. Mass has density is okay, but density has mass is incorrect. If the order is inverted, it cannot be the option. It has to have the same order. So water, ocean. Water has depth, ocean has fathoms. Right? Yes. So if the order is reversed, it cannot be the answer. Therefore, B cannot be the answer. Yes. So that is why, guys, you cannot mark any other option. Option is E. So going to the 21, blood forms a clot. The blood can form a clot. Now give me the answer to 21. Yes, Kamal Nath, I am doing a many series of vocabulary classes. Please join the vocabulary classes. Yes, join the Plus program with, subscribe with the Plus program with Core 10. You will get a 10% discount too. Yes. Yes, guys, blood when it touches air forms a clot. What is the answer to this one? Yes, correct. Now everyone is giving me correct answers. Siddharth, Pooja, Vaishnavi. Depth is how deep the water is, right, Pawan? Yes, depth is how deep the water is. Yes, B is the answer. So milk can curdle. So when milk spoils, it becomes a curdle. So blood becomes a clot. When milk bacteria acts upon it, it begins to curdle, and therefore we form paneer. Right, guys? So answer is B, correct. Okay, going to 22. Piston power engine. So piston is a part of a power engine, right? Yes. What is the answer? A piston is a part of the power engine. What is the answer, guys? Whole and part. This is the part. Yes, Shakil, this will also come for CMAT because this is vocabulary questions. Yes. Power engine is the whole. Yes, guys. So answer will be C is the answer. Wings are the part. Aeroplane is the whole. Yes, a pistol does not necessarily have a bullet. You have to put a bullet in it, right? Yes, liner is a kind of a ship. So you go on a cruise in a liner. But the answer is C, and everyone is giving me C as the answer. Bullet is not part of the pistol, always. Only if you put a bullet, it becomes a part, while wings are always there in an aeroplane. Okay, 24. Cadaver dead. So cadaver is a dead body. Yes, cadaver is a dead body. Cadaver has no life, it is dead. Yes, cadaver has no life, it is dead. So what will be the answer, guys? Yes, question number 24. Correct. Shibu, Vaishnavi, yes, Ayush, Ranjana, Gunjan, a corpse is lifeless, a cadaver is dead, a corpse is lifeless, none of the others will fit. Word is meaningful, always not necessary. Yes, word is not always meaningful. Like if I am trying to give you a word, this is the characteristic. A corpse is lifeless. Yes, D will not fit, guys. Death is not eternal. How do you say death can be final? Right? Eternal is to continue, immortal. So that is why A is the answer, guys. Yes. Okay. So there are some words which have no meaning. They are not meaningful. So that is why we cannot mark word is meaningful. Okay. Yes. Pistol, trigger. So a pistol is a hole and trigger is a part. Yes. What will be the answer? Pistol, trigger ka kya hoega? Answer. A pistol has a trigger. Correct. I'm getting correct answers. Pawan, a sword is placed in a scabbard. This is the cover of the scabbard. Yes. Door has a knob. No, guys, it is a motor and switch. A motor has a switch. So when you use a pistol, it is set into motion with a trigger. Similarly, a motor is put into motion with a switch. So it will be C and not D. This is also whole and part, but how do you cause it to activate? A pistol is activated with a trigger. A motor is activated with a switch. Right? So that is why we will look at C, which is a closer option than E. Right, guys? So answer will be C. Is that fine? Rifle is a weapon. It's not whole and part, right? Yes. So Nishant, it cannot be D. Answer is C. Okay? Yes. Going to the next one is known as, what is known as degree relationship. Degree. So cabin is supposed to be an enclosure, yes, which is a bigger enclosure. So it is a higher degree. Cabin is higher degree. That means it is an enclosure, but a caboose is a small enclosure. So this is known as a smaller degree. So sometimes in an office you have a cabin, right? Yes, cabin is slightly bigger than a caboose. Caboose is smaller. Now tell me which is the one which will fit. Yes, all those students who are watching my video, if you like my teaching style, please give me a like. Please like the video, share the video. I'm also taking classes in the evening, guys. 5:30 in the evening is a critical reasoning class, which is free. So please join me for a critical reasoning class on the Unacademy Learner app at 5:30. And also those who wish to subscribe, please go ahead and subscribe. Yes, use code 10, you will get a 10% discount. Yes, Mansi, 26 is B. Bedroom, kitchen is whole and part. We are looking at degree relationship. Yes, that's why. Kushi, it will be hospital. Hospital is a higher degree. It is big. Hospice is also a kind of a hospital where terminally ill people are kept, but it is smaller degree. Right? So that is why the answer will be E. Hospital, hospice. Yes, hospice is a small hospital where people who are terminally ill, like cancer patients who know that they are not going to survive, they go and admit themselves in a hospice. Right? Yes, that is why it is a smaller degree. Therefore, the answer is E. You have to know the meaning, guys. Only then you can mark the answer. Right? Okay, I'm going to go to 27. So poetry has a rhyme. You have a rhyme scheme. Like so, if the first sentence and the third sentence will rhyme, then the second and the fourth will rhyme. Right? So this is known as a rhyme scheme. Right? So it's called a rhythm. So what is the answer, guys, here? So this is known as a characteristic relationship. A poetry always has a rhythm or a rhyme. So what is the answer? We'll eliminate this word. Yes, which one, guys? Yes, so poetry has a rhyme, a story has a moral. Yes, this one is the one. Yes, it's not always necessary that a mystery has a suspense. It is mystery, but it's not necessarily a suspense. So therefore, the answer will be E, guys. Not Shakespeare and drama. Shakespeare writes drama. No, but Shakespeare also wrote poetry. So you cannot say that Shakespeare and drama will be the answer. Right? So the answer is E, guys. E is the answer. Okay? Yes, 28. Computer has a RAM. Again, what is known as a part and whole relationship. So you have whole and part. So what is the answer, guys? 28. Yes, what is the answer to 28? Again, C. Table has a tablecloth? No. Not all tables have tablecloth. Yes, correct. Ranjana, Anisha, Rugved, Chetana, book and page. Right? The book has a page. So this is a whole, this is a part. This is a whole, this is a part. Right? So therefore the answer will be A. Yes, parable is a story. So when you're telling a story, it's known as a parable. It's not necessarily written in poem form. So this one was easy. Answer is A. Very good, guys. Okay, let's continue. Yes, cell chromosome. Cell has a chromosome. Right, so what will be the answer to 29? Again, whole and part. Why not D? In which one? Sky has vastness. This is known as, it's not a whole and part. Sky is vast is okay, but it's not a whole and part relationship. Book and page is a whole and part relationship. Right? This may be a characteristic relationship where you say the sky is very big. But we are talking about a whole and part relationship. Yes, coming to cell and chromosome. Yes, 29 D and E. Yes, which one, guys? Let us discuss 29. Yes, again a whole and part relationship. What will be the answer? Yes, correct. So air has oxygen. Air has oxygen. Tree has leaves. Some trees don't have leaves. Right? Some pine trees may not have leaves. So therefore, air has oxygen, guys. This will be the answer. Correct? Okay, so answer is D. Yes, D is the answer. Let us go to 30. Radical, moderate. Radical is a person who thinks very laterally. He's a lateral thinker. So moderate is a person who is not very strong-minded. He is average-minded. Yes, average-minded. Yes, so what is the answer to 30? Radical, moderate. Opposites. Yes, guys. Which one are you answering? 30 or 29? Yes, revolutionary, conservative are opposites. Yes, revolutionary, conservative are opposites, right? Yes, these are opposites. Robust is mighty. Epicurean is a pleasure seeker. Pleasure seeker. So is it with Sybarite. Yes, Sybarite is also a pleasure seeker. Yes, it cannot be grotesque is something which is very, very strange. Strange looking. And quixotic, what does this word quixotic mean? Quixotic is a visionary. Quixotic is a visionary. Right, guys? So the answer is D, revolutionary conservative. Okay? Yes, let us go to the next one. Ocean has saline in it. Ocean is salty. Ocean has saline in it. It is salty. Right. So what is the answer to 31? Yes, what is the answer to 31, guys? Correct, Ranjana. A is the answer. So the quality of honey is always sweet. Honey is always sweet. Very good. Okay, going to the next one is 32. Agency, organization. So agency and organization. Agency is a smaller part of a bigger organization. Yes, small part and this is big. Small and big. Right? So what is the answer, guys? Sister, brother cannot be Kushi. So agency is a small part of a bigger organization. Yes, Vaishnavi, what? Why not C for this one? It's the quality of the taste, right? This is talking about taste. So ocean has salt, honey is sweet. So rose is red, is color. So it cannot be C, right? Yes, and this one is E, guys. Infant is small, child is also small, but infant is very small and child is a little bigger than that. Right, so answer will be E. Night sleep does not make sense. Sister, brother, mother, parent, father, mother, no relationship, guys. Okay, so answer is E. Correct, Chirayu? Yes, are you fine? Okay, fur is used to cover an animal. Fur is used to cover an animal. Yes, can you correct this for me? Yes, fur is used to cover an animal, guys. Yes, what will be the answer to this one? Yes, Ranjana, Rukved. Sweater is used to cover a human being. A coat is covering a shirt. No, milk, water, theater, stage, trousers, suit. Does not make sense. So A is the answer. Very good. Okay. Cloud has a silver lining. A cloud has a silver lining. What will be the answer? Yes, what will be the answer, guys? Cloud has a silver lining. Is not A, guys. Yes, A is the answer, 33. Sorry, 34. Talking about 34. Yes, 34, guys. Yes, what is the answer here? Which one, guys? You are saying perfume has odor. No, I think it is C. C is the answer because a cloud is negative, silver lining is positive, a rose is okay, 1 minute. Okay, no, it can't be C. What is the answer? Aircraft has a wing. Perfume has odor. Silver lining is like, sometimes when you have a cloud, the outside has the light of the sun. So you feel the light of the sun here, right? Yes. So that is why. So what is the answer, guys? E is the answer. Perfume has odor. So this is a characteristic relationship. Characteristic relationship. Perfume has odor. Yes, answer will be E. Yes, perfume has odor. That means the smell. Right? Yes. Okay, go to 35. Cane, bamboo. So where do you get cane from? From the bamboo plant. Where do you get cane from? From the bamboo plant. Yes, what is the answer, guys? Yes. Clouds are dark, Chetna. So silver lining, you say every cloud has a silver lining is a saying, right? Every cloud has a silver lining, we say. Yes. Okay, the answer is timber. Timber is got from trees. Timber is got from trees, right? So this will be the answer. Woodpecker is the name of a bird. Yes. Okay. Going to B. Yes, bells jingle. So this is known as collocation. Collocation or sounds. Right, so bells jingle. Yes, what will be the sound? Yes, what is the sound of bells jingling, guys? Yes, waiting for the answer. Crow caws is the sound of a bird, right? Yes, can't be. No, guys, it's not A. Yes, 36 is B. Anklets. Anklets is what you call pile. The pile that you wear is tinkling sound. They tinkle, right? So trinkets are jewelry. Small earrings is called trinkets. So they don't necessarily chime, right? So that is why, as this is the sound, bells jingle, anklets tinkle. Crow's caw is the sound of the bird. So those will be the call of the bird. And that is why this will not fit, guys. Yes, A will not fit. Okay, let's go to 37. Cogent and convincing are synonyms. Something which is logical is cogent and convincing. Logical will be cogent and convincing. Yes. Okay, so what is the answer? 37. 37, few more and we are done, guys. Cogent is a very, the argument is very cogent and convincing, you say. Both are synonyms. Yes, waiting for the answer to come from you. It can't be D, Shibu. So insane is a person who is mad. Illogical, reasonable are opposites. Right? Jovial is very, very funny. Abstruse is mysterious. We have to find synonyms, pertinent and relevant. Pertinent is relevant. So this is the opposite. Answer is laconic and pithy. That means using few words. Laconic is very brief. Brief and pithy is laconic, guys. So therefore the answer will be B. Is that fine? Okay. Nayan, best newspaper RC is Hindu, the Hindu. Yes, death gallows. So when you are hung to death, you are sent to the gallows. Right? So death happens when you go to the gallows. What will be the answer, guys? Yes, what is the answer to 38? Yes, 38. Yes, I'm waiting for the answer to come up for question number 38. Correct. 38 is E. Gaol is also a kind of prison. Right? Gaol is also a kind of prison. Yes. Okay. A judge goes to court. How is that parallel? How is C parallel, guys? So both of them are synonyms. When you go to the gallows, you are hung and you die. Gaol is prison. Read the whole paper, Nayan. Yes, read the whole paper. Yes, reading is what you need to do. Yes, this is known as prison, guys. G-O-A-L is a prison. Yes, it's the name of, it's also another word for prison. They are synonyms. Foundation, edifice. Edifice is a building. So, a building has a foundation. What is the answer? 39. So, what is a foundation is to edifice as yes, a foundation is to an edifice as yes, what is the answer, guys? D is the answer. Oxygen is to life. Yes, oxygen is necessary for life and a foundation is necessary for a building. So therefore, the answer is D. Very good. Okay, 40. Now, these are known again as collective nouns. Collective noun. So you say pride of lions. Yes. Yes. So what is the collective noun for pride of lions, guys? Yes, this is one collective noun, which is the one which is similar. Monikesh is saying whale is a consort. Consort is like a friend, right? So how is it whale and consort? So is supposed to be an adult swine. Sty is where the pig lives. Yes, horse kind of stallion. So the answer will be B, guys. A litter of puppies. A litter of puppies is known as the collective noun. Litter of puppies. Yes. It's not E, it is B. B is the answer. Correct. Yes. Okay. 41. Penury and affluence. Opposites. Penury is poverty. Affluence is being rich. Penury and poverty. Penury is poverty. Affluence is rich. What is the answer, guys? 41. Yes, what is the answer to 41, guys? We have just few more slides and we are done. Yes, very good, Shibu. Taciturnity, verbosity. Correct. Yes, taciturn is use of few words. Verbosity is excess use of words. Excess use of words is known as verbosity. Taciturn is being brief. Right? You have to know the meanings. Interrogation is not an accusation. You're accusing somebody of a crime? No. Garnishment is a decoration. So when you make a dish and you decorate it, it is called garnishment. Yes, taciturnity is brief, verbosity is the opposite, condemnation and mischief, indigence is poverty. These are synonyms. We are looking for opposites. Yes, good morning Nilesh, how are you? Yes guys, are you able to follow? Yes, okay, let's go to 42. Machiavellian. Machiavellian is a person who is very cunning and deceptive. Cunning and deceptive. So this is known as a characteristic relationship. So Machiavellian people are always deceitful. Always deceitful. So this is known as a characteristic relationship. Like if I say an egoist is full of self, an altruist is selfless. So Machiavellian is always deceitful. What will be the answer? Yes, what is the answer, guys? Good morning, Himanshu. How are you? What is characteristic, guys? Very good. Shibu is giving me the correct answer. It's not amphibious plants. Amphibian animals are which can live on land and water, right? Yes, not D is the answer. A person who is naive is gullible, simplistic. So you say the village folk are very naive or gullible people, or they are simplistic people. They will believe anything that you tell them. So that is the meaning, guys. Ingenious is intelligent. Very intelligent person is known as ingenuity. So therefore, this will not fit, right? Yes, accusative means to accuse somebody of a crime. If you do something wrong, you are accused of a crime. Cunning means chalak. Yes, bahut chalak and sabko deceive karna, cheat karna, to cheat somebody. Right? Yes. Okay, guys, going to 43. Opposites. Benevolent is a person who is very generous. Grasping is a person who is stingy, miserly. Yes, benevolent, grasping are opposites. What will be the answer, guys? Yes, cunning means clever, but in a negative way, Shibu. It means in a negative way. Yes, clever is positive. Okay, guys. What is the answer to 43? Very good. Shibu is giving me the correct answer. Yes, Mansi, very good. So euphonious. Euphonious, EU is good, phon is sound. So good sound or harmonious sound. Harmonious sound is called euphonious. Discordant is a harsh sound. Harsh sound is called discordant. Yes, rebellious, disorderly means being a mess. This does not go. And a person who is churlish is very rude. Is very rude person. So, rude and impolite is what it cannot be, because this particular person is also always complaining or crude. Complaining or crude. Right. So that is why the answer churlish and impolite will be synonyms. We are looking for opposites. Intrepid is fearless. Fearless. Repulsive is horrible. Something which you totally dislike is repulsive. Yes, so fearless, adventurous will also be to some extent synonyms. Right, guys? So answer is B. Is it clear? Okay. Yes, Vaishnavi, what is the doubt? 44. Fraud, frighten, petrify. Petrify means to turn to stone with fear. So both of them are synonyms. So I was petrified. That means when you see a ghost, you are petrified. You turn to stone, right? Yes. So what is the synonym, synonymous one here? Yes, what are the synonyms, guys? Last two slides and we are done. Yes, waiting for the answer. Very good. Shibu is giving me correct answer. Answer will be humiliate and mortify, which means to insult. To insult. Both of them are synonyms. Enamor means to attract. Protect will not fit. Sneer is to look down on someone. Right? So this one will be opposites. Abbreviate is to shorten. Does not go. Heckle is to mock. Right? So, yes, guys. So answer is D. Humiliate, mortify. Both of them are insulting and they are synonyms. Is that fine? So the last slide coming up, munificent, stingy. Munificent is a person who is generous. Stingy is a person who is miserly. Conjuice. Conjuice person is stingy. So what is the answer? Yes, opposites, guys. Yes, inclement is very severe and harsh weather. Yes. It can't be C because articulate is the way you speak. Articulate is very eloquent. Yes, you speak very eloquently. Obscure is something which is not clear. Yes, so it's not necessarily this one, guys. Answer is D. Egregious is very bad. Outstanding is very good. Yes, eloquent is also the way you speak, articulate, you speak well, right? To speak well is being eloquent. Explicit is to explain. Incorrigible is a person who cannot be reformed. Cannot be reformed. Do your parents tell you you are incorrigible ever? Yes. Okay, and recalcitrant is disobedient. Yes. Yes, egregious is outstandingly bad, but egregious is very bad and outstanding itself is very good. He's a very outstanding student. Yes. Yes, Vaishnavi. Is it clear, guys? Is it fine? Okay, so this was the last slide. Yes, this was the slide. So I am ready to conduct a quiz. How many of you will join the quiz? Because in recent times, I don't find too many students staying for the quiz. So if you want me to conduct the quiz, tell me how many of you will join. Yes. Yes, guys, how many of you are ready to join? That is the end of today's class. The verbal ability section is taken care of me, 9:30 to 10:30. Continues in the evening from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. Right? So on hashtag cat live daily. Download the Telegram app livedaily.me/chat and join the Telegram chat. Yes, so Unacademy subscription is the best in the industry. Yes, Nagina, you can join. Okay. So I will do a quiz on vocabulary today, guys. After the class, I will put up the code. Please join the quiz. Okay. Yes, Nagina, you have to download the Unacademy Learning app. Please download the Unacademy Learning app. Which passages, Nilesh? You can read any newspapers. It is good for you. Yes. Okay, so I will do a quiz, guys. I will do a quiz after this class. Please join me for the quiz. So go ahead and join the subscription. Live classes, interact with the educator, live polls, test series and doubt clearing sessions. Those who have never done the quiz, guys, download the learning app, Unacademy learning app, install the app, go for the plus courses. You have many, many CAT courses. Yes, Vaishnavi, I will put up the code now only on this group after I go offline. Yes, after I go offline, I will put up the code on this group. Please wait. So get your subscription, guys. The CAT subscription is the best in the industry. 1,458 for 12 months, 875 for 24 months. If you use Core 10, you will get a further 10% discount. Yes, even if you don't have a subscription, you can join the quiz. Yes, Nilesh, please read the Hindu newspaper. Yes, even if you have not subscribed, you can join the quiz, guys. Quiz is free. Yes, so use Core 10 to get a further 10% discount. Yes, even if you're doing NEET, JEE, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, guys, any of the courses, please use Core 10 and subscribe. So subscribe, like, share, hashtag CatLifeDaily, download the PDF. Please use my referral code Core10, get 10% off. Please stay on the group, guys. I will log out and then I will also put up the code on this group itself. Please wait for the code. And can you please help those students who have never done the quiz and on how to join the quiz? Right, guys? In the meantime, please instruct people who don't know how to join the quiz. Fine. So that